Welcome, friends. It's exciting to study God's Word together. And this week, we will look at praise and how praise is so powerful in our lives. When we talk about praising God, for many of us, that reminds us of the first few songs that we sing on a Sunday morning, some of the fast songs, and that's the end of praise. But there is so much more to praising God. What is praise? When we see praise in scripture, we understand that praise is a verbal declaration of who God is. So we are adoring God and we are confirming, acknowledging who He is with our words. And that is praise. Praise is a choice that we make. I like to read from Psalms 9 and verse 1. It says, I will praise you, O Lord, with my whole heart. I will tell of all your marvelous works. Here the psalmist uses I will to tell us that he is making a choice. Now, what if he said, I won't? Things are so bad that I won't praise you, O Lord. But he is saying, I will praise you, O God. So it's a choice that he has made. Now, you and I, in our life circumstances, we are aware that not every season is favorable. We could be going through some seasons that are hard and rough. But in every season, we do not have to depend on how we feel when it comes to praising God. Praising God is beyond our feeling. So we can make a choice, and like the psalmist, we too can say, I will praise the Lord. I will tell of all His marvelous works. Now, how is it possible to praise God when things are difficult? It's very simple. We have to shift our focus from what is going on in this finite temporal world, and we have to look at the eternal things of God. We have to look at God and His nature. And as we begin to do this, we'll realize that we are serving a mighty God. Scriptures tell us that our God, He is mighty in righteousness. He is mighty in the marvelous works that He does. He is mighty, has a mighty name. He is mighty in His salvation. He is mighty in His power. He is mighty in His strength. So when we shift our focus from our inabilities, from the many things that are not going right, we are actually looking deep into who God is, and that begins to occupy all of who we are. And when we do that, when we shift our focus, it becomes a lot easier for us to recognize who God is and then begin to speak that out with our words. Now, this does not mean that we deny the facts around us. The reality of life doesn't change, but we are making a choice by shifting our focus and by saying, I will praise the Lord. At all times, as Psalm 34 says, I will praise the Lord, I will bless the Lord at all times. It's a choice that you and I need to make. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, we thank you that God, there is so much in you, O God, that Lord, we can keep praising. And God, we can never exhaust praising, Father God. We cannot bring enough of praises to you because you are worthy. You are worthy. And Lord, we pray that you will fill our hearts, Lord, with revelation of who you are, so that like the heavenly creatures, moment by moment, God, we will cry out, holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty. Thank you, God. Thank you for opening our eyes to who you are, that we may bring your praises. And we will praise you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.